Hey there guys, what's up? It's JP here. I'm back in the next part of my Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls playthrough. You'll forgive me for the lack of content on my channel recently. I've just been really busy. So let us take
hey
a look
lady,
here.
I got some new things. You should take a look.
Doesn't look like there's too many people who want to talk. I think we got the noise.
A week ago, I was deafened by the voices. Council members argued in the corridors outside my chambers. Guards chanted on their patrols and scribes murmured incessantly. Out here, there is only the wind.
Sounds really wonderful, I guess. And looks like we've got some Christmas things going on here. All experience rewards are increased by 100%. That's really nice. See you there.
Dark.
Anything new to say?
What happened?
I've dug up some new things for you to take a look at.
You have the heat.
I do not feel well.
I'm not surprised. You've been out in the sun for hours.
I can't leave. The Emperor will come to his senses any moment now.
Take some of my water, you fool.
Nice outfit you got there.
It seems bad out here, but inside the walls is where the...
And let's see if we have the next part here. There we go.
Chaldeum changed drastically in recent years when the Kurast nobles all but invaded the city. Soon after, their emperor, Hakan I, joined them and made Chaldeum his capital. Though his actions seemed audacious, he managed to bring further peace and prosperity to the city for the duration of his reign.
The city.
You cannot trust anyone in this cesspit.
I know what you mean. Just yesterday.
I can just teleport back.
To town.
Probably not faster than actually running there, but whatever. Let's see what Tyriel has
you
to say.
You seem to have survived the Worldstone's destruction.
The resultant explosion dispersed the light and harmony of my angelic being. Without form or shape, I restored myself within the realm of Pandemonium. It took me 20 of your years, but finally, I returned home to the high heavens.
Were your brothers in arms glad for your return?
Hardly. Believing my actions had endangered creation, the Angiris Council put me, the Archangel of Justice, on trial. I knew then that heaven was doomed unless I could enlist the aid of mankind against the coming onslaught of hell.
You okay?
I'm surprised Cain never told you why I left. He knew I was called to fight the Lords of Hell, and I knew he would keep you safe.
He's gone now.
Then it's fate that we have been reunited. Cain's work, your work, is my war.
According to the Herodric texts, only two evils remain. Belial is here in Chaldeum, and Asmodan has yet to reveal himself.
Nothing stops the crusade!
All right. Looks like we don't have any takers here. We have something new here.
This Adria, I sense dark things about her. She is not averse to using whatever means necessary to destroy Asmodan and Belial. She will use the Black Soulstone, no matter what the cost.
She is right. The demon lords must die.
Some costs may prove too high. Even for you.
So I kind of want to play around the Phalanx ability, but we'll see.
I worry about Leah. How is she?
Why do you ask?
Oh, no reason. She just needs someone looking out for her. This Zoltan Kool sounds like an untrustworthy fellow. You don't have your head separated from your body for no good reason.
We need him to get the Soul Stone.
Well, if you must. But I don't trust any of those ancient sorcerer types. Always up to no good.
So let's talk to Adria for a bit.
Do you regret abandoning Leah?
What? No, I never saw it that way. She grew up in safety. While I risked my life to find the key to our salvation, it was the sacrifice that I had to make. In any case, Leah will meet her full potential under my guidance. Do you not have things to do?
Right.
How well did you know Cain?
For a time, during the darkening of Tristram, we spent many nights in the Tavern of the Rising Sun, discussing his Herodric texts and the varied arcana I'd collected during my travels.
Did you ever see him again?
Only from afar. From time to time, our paths would cross, and I would catch glimpses of Leah as she grew. It broke my heart that I could not reveal myself and raise her as my own.
Yeah, okay.
How did you come to be captured?
I was trying to steal out of the city. I'd returned to gather some things before setting out to recover Zoltan Kul's head, and the guards found me.
Story checks out for now.
I take it your wife was not burned at the stake for witchcraft.
I broke her out in the middle of the night and we escaped. They didn't chase us far. I guess they were glad to see her go.
You risked your life for someone you didn't even know. Not many would do that.
She wasn't a witch. She was a mystic. Though we didn't find that out for a time. Not until we started traveling with a Vechen wagon train. But that's a story for another time.
And one that we will hear. So let's see what she has. Apparently nothing new here. Should a gem guy have something to say? No? Then let's just get on to our quest.
The guards were asking you about this black soul stone. I remember reading about it in Uncle's journal, but it didn't seem important.
No, but it is. It is the key to defeating evil forever. It was created by the mage Zoltan Kul to trap demonic souls.
Yes, he was a renegade Herodrim, dismembered by his brethren before he could activate the Soul Stone. His head was sealed away in the Dolgar Oasis.
We must retrieve it, because if we're to use the Soul Stone to defeat Belial and Asmodan, Zoltan Kul must live again.
Hmm. Got a mini cutscene here.
We rescued Leah's mother, Adria. She told us about the Black Soul Stone, an artifact that could banish evil forever.
Okay,
I that must seems so. Find it.
So we're off to find the Black Soul Stone here. And since it's been a while since I made this, we might actually go all the way to that Zoltan Kul.
Murderer, torturer, monster. These were the titles bestowed upon Zoltan Kul by the Herodrim, though it cost them dearly. They killed the wizard for his crimes against nature and sealed his broken corpse within a shadow realm. It seems they were afraid he might return.
And with good reason.
300 years ago, I selected Kul and six others to form the Herodrim. He was a great man who was driven mad by his long quest to hunt evil.
Why did the Herodrim kill Zoltan Kul?
He delved into powers not meant for man, trying to fashion an artifact that could fill his empty heart with the souls of angels and demons. The Herodrim had no choice but to slay him. The Order never recovered.
All right.
Zoltan Kul, a legend. There is no doubt in my mind he is as powerful as the stories say. But for every bit of his genius, he was surely mad. He was obsessed with immortality and power.
A madman. We would do better to leave him asleep in the desert than to call on him for aid.
You have a better idea.
I do not. It is merely a warning.
All right.
I don't like dealing with Kul any better than you do, but I see no other way. If Adria says we must, then we must. Uncle Deckard trusted her. And so will I.
Zoltan Kul is an unknown. Involving him is risky.
You take risks every day, Crusader. And one dismembered wizard is nothing compared to Belial and Asmodan.
That's kind of true. So hopefully there's no one else that needs to stay here. Yeah, nothing else here. So let's go down to the city. And we'll see if we can get any extras here. I might have accidentally clicked on one of these. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I accidentally clicked on that a while ago. part five.
All was well under the new emperor until his untimely death forced the Zakharum priests to find a new heir for Kejistan's throne. Through a series of elaborate rituals, undoubtedly a spectacle for their superstitious followers, they determined an impoverished infant in the north was Hakan the First.
It's disgusting. I've seen that woman going in and out of the
city. Wow, that guy's such
a
spoiler.
We have a visitor up ahead.
And nothing here. Here we go.
The Valrus manuscript lists Asmodan as the best battlefield commander of all demons, having defeated the angels many times in the eternal conflict across Pandemonium and the prime evils in the demonic civil war. If the Lord of Sin ever assaults our realm, we truly have much to fear.
Listen to me. I cannot talk for long, but Lyle's guards are constantly watching me.
Emperor Hakan?
Forgive me for my behavior at court. The guards would have killed me had I sided with you, but I will help you now as I can. You must be headed to the Oasis. I can open this gate for you.
What a creepy little boy, yeah?
How did all this happen?
There's little I can do. Between my advisors and the Imperial Guard, my every move and action are controlled. I have tried to fight back, but Belial's influence is strong. But now you've given me a chance. Perhaps my only chance.
How can you aid me?
You're here to kill Belial, aren't you? I can help.
Perhaps in a few years.
I can still fight in my own way. I want my empire back. I will find where Belial is hiding and deliver him to you.
Okay.
I'm not sure I trust you after you set your guards on us.
I told you it was not my choice. My every move is controlled and I'm surrounded by enemies. But I swear to you, I will help you. I will prove it to you.
Mm-hmm. Sure, we'll get back to this kid in a while. So let's find the Black Soulstone. Got a Frenzied Shrine. Not sure how helpful that's gonna be.
That is a powerful foe over there.
That's a new
the
law.
Deserts of Kejistan are majestic, expansive, and full of stinging swarms of insects. They may seem a minor nuisance, but these vermin carry numerous strains of pestilence. One of them was trapped in my boot once, and my foot swelled up to the size of a melon before the infection cleared. What horrible creatures! Though the champions are larger, and the lunatics more devastating, it is the shaman priests who lead the fallen. These shrunken, unintimidating demons can easily kill an enemy with their firebolts, but it is their ability to resurrect their imp allies that allows them to command such high respect from their peers.
Uh-huh. There you go.
Diablo was the youngest of the prime evils, but I found him the most dangerous, for his power over Terra left him incapable of feeling fear. Though he had easily possessed and corrupted many humans, Diablo's essence was finally trapped in a soul stone and banished to the unfathomable abyss 20 years ago.
For some reason, I'm only an expert here. I might have to go ahead and increase the difficulty if I can here. Maybe in the next video.
The crusade marches on. Patience. I require more wrath.
Probably not gonna map it up like I used to.
Not enough wrath.
So we just go ahead and run around, I guess. Or rather, we'll try not to run around too much. Try to get straight to the objective, which I managed to. Alright.
It is so beautiful.
To those who doubt my achievements in research, I present my findings on the Dune Dervish. It took me many years to find the truth of these strange, deadly figures. But my sources indicate that they are the cursed remains of mages who summoned a demon far beyond their power to control.
Pandariel was the only female evil. She aided the lesser evils for many years, but eventually she lost faith in their plots. 2 decades ago, she chose to help Diablo during his resurgence and seize the Citadel of the Sightless Eye. Ultimately, she perished at the hands of brave heroes.
It is easy to focus on the dangerous foes one may encounter on the ground, but the Bloodhawks rule the skies with terrible ferocity. These crimson-winged birds...
Someone help!
And once again got spoiled there, but...
Oh, thank you.
These guys fairly have anything of use here.
Not ready yet.
Oops. You know what, I'm quite liking this phalanx ability. Seems really strong.
Help me, please! Someone help!
You fool! Quiet! Or I will rip your tongue from your mouth.
Thank you. Those vile creatures were looting my goods. Now that you have saved me, I'd be happy to allow you the privilege of buying them instead.
I can't do that.
I don't want to repair it, I want to sell it here. Sell. Let's swap this and then sell that.
The enemy has destroyed Alcarnus and most of the cultists. The master commands us to capture more slaves immediately. Go to the oasis and abduct the villagers. Kill any who resist. That way we shall both gain allies and destroy enemies.
And looks like we
if
got
I
there.
The head of a deranged sorcerer. I'll hide it here.
So seems like I'm getting pretty lucky here.
Serve me.
If you insist, but let's just ignore those and go in here.
Dark magic fills this place.
We are in agreement. Kul, the renegade, must be stopped. He seeks to duplicate the power of the storms and wield it for his own ends. He is obsessed with the powers of heaven and hell. Drawing their attention will only bring doom to us all.
Okay.
Only the most talented mages can summon skeletal guardians. It takes great power to form these tall, slim constructs from their unstable reagents, and even more power to sustain them. In the hands of a master, however, the guardians can become powerful weapons capable of defending their posts until the end of time.
Not all dangerous demons are large and imposing. The dust imps are little more than children in size, but they possess the cunning and bloodlust of far larger creatures. They take cover in the shadows, emerging only when viable prey wanders too close. Then they ambush, leaving little more than bones behind them.
Oh, how disappointing. There's like no good loot here. Demonic essence, no longer a thing. Oops, wrong key there.
Cower before Zakaroon!
And I got a chest up here. Again, lacking some good loot. Believe it or not, my first legendary I ever found in Diablo was from one of these. It was a chess piece, I think.
Most impressive. Burn in the light.
Man, am I leveling up fast today? I guess the 100% bonus is pretty significant.
My wrath is low.
A powerful enemy we have laid low.
Whoa.
Not enough wrath.
There we go. That was terrible.
We set out in 1 week's time into the desolate sands to search for Kul's hidden archives. None of us have any idea what to expect. How far has Kul's madness driven him? How much power has he accumulated in his mad quest? I can only hope we are not too late.
I am returning to town.
The only reason I do this is because just in case I get stuck returning back in there.
New goods.
If you keep holding back, then you'll never improve. It is time, Leah. Cast the spell as I taught you.
I live again.
Zoltan Kul. We need you to activate the Black Soul Stone. We would use it to trap the last two Lords of Hell.
I know your voice, stranger. It has haunted me in death. Just as it commanded me in life, Tyriel.
I am, but now mortal.
Ah, fate is whimsical.
Alright. So let's just do all the talking here.
Have you ever fought Belial?
Not openly. He was never one to lead an army. Always in the shadows, much like his mentor Mephisto. He wields intrigue and artifice as proficiently as you wield your weapons.
I miss Uncle Deckard so much. It's hard going on without him.
He lives in your memory, Leah. Take comfort in that.
Thank you. I'm going to get back to my research.
After surviving the devastation in Tristram all those years ago, I swore...
After surviving the devastation in Tristram all those years ago, I swore vengeance
upon Diablo and his ilk. I've sacrificed everything for it. This is my path, and I will follow it through to its bloody end.
Oh, it's going to be bloody, all right.
Leah thinks highly of you.
She has a kind heart.
There are worse qualities.
Kindness will not help us survive in these dark times.
No, they won't.
The Lord of Lies is cunning. He wears many masks to hide his shifting nature from us. But we will have an advantage over him. The Black Soul Stone. Belial fears its power, for Soul Stones have bested his siblings in the past, and he could be imprisoned as well.
All right. That's such a scoundrel.
You speak of women often. But have you ever actually loved one?
Ah, yes.
The unreasonable one I spoke of earlier. I loved her with every inch of my heart before it went black as coal.
What happened to her?
Well, she did what all unreasonable women do. Married the wrong man.
You didn't stop them?
It wouldn't have been easy. He was my brother.
Right, love triangles are complicated, aren't they? Nothing here. Looks like Leah hasn't been doing her job. Supposed to be writing stories for us to read here. Let's see what Hadrick has to say.
Did you and your wife enjoy your time at the Vetchin?
We did. They saw two lost souls in love and on the run. They thought it was unbearably romantic. I suppose it might have even been true. One of their mystics saw Mira's talent and trained her in their art. We traveled with them for a time, and we fell in love. Do you know what it is to love someone?
A crusader loves her faith, her shield, and her cause.
A pity. None of those can love you back.
Oh, this is interesting. Should we play with this for a little bit here? Where is it? See what that's like. And looks like little companions are finding new clothes here.
I was just another highborn courtier in the palace. But I dreamed of being a famous poet like Solan. Have you read his work? It makes your heart sing. My ability is nowhere near his, but I suppose you will see that for yourself. When the desert sands silence their whispers in the night, and the thousand lights of the stars bleed into the darkness, I will find you in the void. My love will pour from me as words pour from my pen.
That sounds terribly cheesy. She's right, she's really bad. Alright, so
we
nothing
need to go
here.
Back.
So I guess we can go on ahead and make this a longer video. I got a couple of hours to go before I can do my thing anyways.
I will give you the Black Soul Stone, but in exchange, I must be made whole once again.
You were treacherous before. How do I know you won't be an even greater threat once you've been fully revived?
You don't. So you must ask yourself, how much would you risk to save this wretched world?
Everything.
Ah, so be it. To begin, you will need to retrieve my blood from the dungeons where it has been hidden away. You will find them in the desolate sands beyond the aqueducts.
I'm going to go with you. We should bring Kool's head with us. Maybe he'll have something useful to say. I'll put him in your bag.
Whatever happened to your sisters?
They should have awakened as well, but their mission has already ended.
How?
I sought out the closest two before I met you. They lay dead in me.
My mother has been teaching me magic and how to control my power, but I feel like I'm constantly disappointing her. She says that I have a gift, but it doesn't feel that way. Maybe it will improve if I keep practicing. For now, we are getting closer to the Black Soul Stone, and that's what really matters.
Alright.
You're an interesting one, aren't you? I wonder if your friends know what you truly are.
Speak plainly.
Oh, all will be revealed in time.
What did you do to earn the hatred of the Herodrim?
I bear the same scars they all did. They knew the truth of it. But the fools buried their heads in the sand. They thought the evils were sealed away, never to trouble us again. They needed a solution. They needed to end it all.
You know what, I'm not entirely sold on this, ability here. We're almost there, though.
You will not enter the aqueducts! Lord Belial demands your blood!
Oh. So yeah, we'll just wait for this to recharge and then get back to it.
I can open this gate for you.
How did you learn of the Soul Stones?
I spent many hours with them as we hunted the three. I studied them, intrigued by their power. In the long years after our victory, I felt an emptiness within me. A bitterness that consumed me.
Emperor Hakon?
Ah, oh, come
we
on,
have time
Emperor.
For pleasantries. I think I may have uncovered Belial's assumed identity. I'm very close. But here's what you need to know. To find Kul's blood, you'll need to get through the aqueducts. There are two levers that control the entrance beneath the waterfall.
Have you located Belial?
Not yet, but I have some ideas. It is difficult. I have many advisors and other attendants close to me day and night. I will find him.
Uh-huh.
How are you able to appear before us?
They keep a close watch on me. I can't leave the palace. I stole an amulet from the Vajera ambassador. I saw him use it before. But I don't have much time. You need to find the stone. Leave Belial to me.
He did not really answer your question. How odd.
It's not odd. It's obviously why. A really obvious why. So we just ignore Kul for now.
There will be fighting here.
It's Belial. So long as he lives, all of Chaldean is under siege. Uncle Deckard theorized that the demon lords leave demons in their wake, much like us leaving footprints.
And you agree?
Yes. The more I study my uncle's books, the more I realize that even I took his wisdom for granted.
Well, we all love Deckard Cain now, don't we? I'm not convinced we're going the right way as usual, but...
Serve me!
Burn in the light!
Well, I guess it has to be right now, right? Yes, indeed. I guess. I don't know.
The electric eels are insidious pests that have taken root in the oases surrounding Chaldeum. Known for their stinging strikes, these creatures are particularly dangerous when they attack in large numbers. It is said that raw eel has become a delicacy among Chaldeum's elite, but I assure you these rumors are baseless.
Our enemies mean to slow our advance. It will not work.
Ooh, Heaven's Fury, that's interesting. So we could try that. I think I would like that a little better than the previous one.
My favorite.
Or it better be. Let's see if anything good here. Doesn't look like it. Yeah, disappointing as always.
Strange magic radiates from these foes.
Oh, that's not too terrible, I think.
Patience.
Had enough?
Looks like I'm going the wrong way again. Oh, maybe not. Yes, okay, yeah. Guess I did.
Not yet.
Let's see here. Wrong way again. Gosh darn it, no matter how many times I play this, like, I always get lost. It's ridiculous.
Had enough.
I require more wrath.
Ah, okay, there we go. Come back here, you fiend. That looks like one, that looks like one.
Like chaff before the wind.
Looks like we're getting a couple of upgrades here. That's pretty nice. And
I see the lever. That's one lever down.
One to go.
These aqueducts did not even exist in my own time.
Looks like we got our first amulet here. Stupid insects, my goodness.
Not ready yet.
Damn, the loot is really bad today.
Like chaff before the wind. Not yet.
Seems like I'm going the wrong way again. Ah, man. It's been so long since I played Diablo. It feels kind of, ironically, it doesn't feel old. It's just kind of weird, even though I've been playing Diablo a while now. And yeah, I am more liberal with, like, spending my gold now. Just because I don't play Diablo as seriously as I did before. Kind of diverse into like a bunch of other games. In fact, ever since I started working, I haven't been gaming as much. Typical.
Well done.
Ah, come on. What a bunch of jerks. Alright, again? Are you kidding me? Yeah, change this to that. Come on. Shoot, glare, consecration. Judgment is... No, I don't want judgment. I don't want you. Phalanx. Bowman. Not too interesting, I think. A loss of hope. What is that? Nah. But nothing too interesting there. There we go. So let's take a quick look here. Slight improvement. The rest of it, not so much.
I miss searching for lost artifacts with Uncle Deckard, even though it did have its dangerous side. I can't tell you how many times I had to drag him away from an army of skeletons because he was fixated on some dusty old tapestry.
Ah, wrong way. Gosh darn it. Typical.
Not ready yet.
So where is it? Is it up and down to the right, I guess?
Not yet.
That passage should lead to the desolate sands.
A secret door hidden behind a waterfall. How imaginative.
You would do better.
You shall see when we get to my archives.
I can't believe he stuck me in a barrel. Really, it's quite uncomfortable in here.
Right, let's we just get out of here and then call it a day, I guess.
This wouldn't be quite so bad. Are you still alive out there? Or is it the monsters?
Thank you for releasing me. It was getting a little boring in there. I am seeking a magic crucible that legend says was hidden in these very aqueducts. It would be a valuable addition to my jeweler's tools. Help me find it, and I will be greatly indebted to you.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Oh, how rude of me. I forgot to introduce myself. My name is Covetous Shen.
And what do you covet, Shen?
Oh, this and that, you'll see. I can't
really
imagine why my young partner bashed me over the head and sealed me in there. This place is quite dangerous without a knowledgeable guide.
And are you such a guide?
Well, I am. Well, I used to live down here long, long ago. But I don't talk about that time.
And you thought I was odd.
Yeah, why am I going that way?
What a fascinating place this is. Oh, look at all this wonderful architecture. You could walk all the way around the world.
The Crusaders swore an oath to dedicate their lives to the search. None believed that they would be the one to end the crusade by finding and cleansing the corruption. They believed the search ennobled them, that the discipline of their life and journey was the true goal. The Crusader was meant to find meaning in the quest itself.
Okay.
Not ready yet.
So I know that this is the right way. I just wanted to hear out there.
Now I wonder where my young guide got off to. His name was Gavin, I believe. Yes, that was it. Nice young fellow. He must still be around here also, or perhaps he got lost? No, we're not lost, are we?
This is a guy who's supposed to be the guide, right?
You know, it was actually quite an interesting experience to be locked up in the barrel. I had a lot of time to think to myself. It was a little uncomfortable, though.
My wrath is low.
A most
crucible! It's mine!
Be careful, Gavin. It might be cursed.
Dear, I did warn him.
The crucible should be safe now. Pick it up. Pick it up.
Poor young man. If I had known the crucible was cursed, I never would have brought him along.
If you come see me in Chaldeum, I can show you how the crucible can combine jewel fragments. Well, you know, I've been searching for a certain jewel for a long, long time. I'm in no rush. But maybe if I go with you, I'll find it just like I found this crucible. May I come with you on your journey and make glorious jewelry for you?
We don't really have a say in the matter now, do we?
I'm going back to town. I need to learn the spell.
Yeah, go ahead and learn the spell. So I guess...
You and I are the same. But those others, the fallen angel, the witch, they're using you for their own ends. You choose to be their puppet, yet the power of your birthright could make you a god.
I haven't the vanity to seek godhood. I leave that to you.
There's no need to be snide. Soon enough, I'll walk this world again. Then I'll show you what a Nephilim can achieve.
Hey, lady! I got some news.
Alright, so we'll just end it at that here. Hopefully you guys didn't find this video too long here, and yeah, I'll have another one for you guys soon. This is JP signing out.